同学们好，今天我们来学习第93课 Lesson 93 Our New Neighbor。 这个小故事是和新邻居 Our New Next Door Neighbor 有关的。好，一起来看课文，并且请你回答这样一个问题。 Why is Nigel a lucky man? 为什么说 Nigel 是一个幸运的人？
Nigel is our new next door neighbor. He's a pilot.He was in the RAF. He will fly to New York next month. The month after next, he'll fly to Tokyo. At the moment, he's in Madrid. He flew to Spain a week ago. He'll return to London the week after next. He's only 41 years old, and he has already been to nearly every country in the world.Nigel is a very lucky man. But his wife isn't very lucky. She usually stays at home.
现在请大家回答这个问题。Why is Nigel a lucky man? Because he has already been to nearly every country in the world. 因为 Nigel 已经去过世界上几乎所有的国家，所以大家都说他是一个幸运的人。好。下面我们一起来看本课中的关键词和词组。Keywords and expressions. Pilot. Return. New York. Tokyo. Madrid. Fly. Fly 是一个不规则动词，它的过去式和过去分词分别是 flew, flown. 好，一起来看本课中的主要语言点。Nigel is our new next door neighbor. He's a pilot.He was in the RAF. Nigel 是我们新搬来的隔壁邻居。Next door neighbor, 隔壁邻居。请大家注意，在美语的拼写中 ,neighbor 这个词是没有字母 u 的。那么如何说 Nigel 就住在隔壁呢？ Nigel lives next door, 或者 Nigel is next door. The RAF, 也就是 The Royal Air Force,英国皇家空军，他曾经在英国的皇家空军任职，曾经是说过去的事情，所以动词用了 was。He will fly to New York next month. Next month, 下个月，说的是将来要发生的事情，所以用了一般将来时 will. Fly to, 飞往什么地方。那么明天是 tomorrow, 下个星期 next week.明年 ,next year. 那么再下个月他会做什么呢？ The month after next, he'll fly to Tokyo. The month after next, 再下个月。再下个月他要飞往东京。The day of tomorrow, 后天。The week after next, 再下个星期。The year after next, 后年。那么现在Nigel 在什么地方呢？ At the moment, 此刻，现在， he's in Madrid, 他正在马德里，也就是西班牙的首都。他是什么时候去西班牙的呢？ He flew to Spain a week ago, 他一个星期以前飞往西班牙的。昨天， yesterday, 一个月以前， a month ago, 一年以前， a year ago. Then, when will he return to London?He'll return to London the week after next. The week after next. 再下个星期。Return to. 返回某个地方。下面谈到了 Nigel 在邻居们的心目中是一个幸运的人。原因是这样的。He's only 41 years old, and he has already been to nearly every country in the world. 他只有41岁。但是他已经去过了世界上几乎所有的国家，已经到过某个地方，我们用 have been to 的形式，因为主语是 he, 所以 have 变成了 has. And 在这个句子中有转折的意思。再来看一个句子。She moved into this neighborhood a week ago, and she has already known everyone. 她一个星期以前才搬来这个街区住的。但是现在他几乎已经认识了所有的人。Nigel is a very lucky man, but his wife isn't very lucky. Nigel 是一个幸运的人，但是他的妻子就没那么幸运了。Then why is his wife unlucky? Because she usually stays at home. 她通常待在家里。这篇课文虽然很短，但是却包括了过去、现在、将来等各个时间段里发生的事件，这一点请大家特别注意。下面我们就重点的来总结一下一般过去时和一般将来时的对比。When did go to? 什么时候去的某个地方 ？When will go to? 什么时候将去某个地方 ？When did he go to New York? He went to New York last week. 他什么时候去纽约的？他是上个星期去纽约的。When will he go to Paris? He'll go to Paris next month. 他什么时候将去巴黎？他下个月将去巴黎。那么这些句子当中的 go to 都可以换成 fly to, return to。好，下面我们再来看一遍课文，请大家跟读，并且注意是怎样描述 Nigel 过去做过什么，现在在哪里，将要到哪里去。
Nigel is our new next door neighbor. He's a pilot. He was in the RAF. He will fly to New York next month. The month after next, he'll fly to Tokyo. At the moment, he's in Madrid. He flew to Spain a week ago. He'll return to London the week after next. He's only 41 years old.And he has already been to nearly every country in the world. Nigel is a very lucky man. But his wife isn't very lucky. She usually stays at home.
好，下面让我们进入句型训练，来练习一下如何表达我过去到过某个地方，或者是我将来要去什么地方。Lesson 94. When did you go to? Or...When will you go to? Athens, 雅典的神庙 Beijing. Will you go to Athens next week? No, I shan't go to Athens next week. Shan't 是 shall not 的缩写形式，但是在现代英语当中常常用 won't 来代替 shan't. I shall go to Beijing. Shall.我们还可以用 will 来代替，而且现代英语中也常常这样说。Berlin, 柏林 Bombay, 孟买 Will you and Jane fly to Berlin this week? No, we shan't fly to Berlin this week. We shall fly to Bombay. Geneva, 日内瓦，这个地球仪象征着世界各国。那么后面的建筑很有可能就是联合国总部了。London, 伦敦的大笨钟。Will Penny return to Geneva next year? No, she won't return to Geneva next year. She will return to London. Madrid, 西班牙斗牛。Moscow, 莫斯科的红场。Will Sam leave for Madrid next month?Leave for, 去往。No, he won't leave for Madrid next month. He will leave for Moscow. New York, 说到纽约，大概人们常常想起的就是摩天大楼了。Paris, 巴黎的埃菲尔铁塔。Will Alice and Mary stay in New York the week after next? No,They won't stay in New York the week after next. They will stay in Paris. Rome, 罗马 Last year, next year. When did you go to Rome? I went to Rome last year. When will you go again? I'll go again next year. So...汉城 last month, 上个月 next month, 下个月 When did Helen come to Seoul? She came last month, When will she come again?
She'll come again next month.
Stockholm.
Where will your friends fly to the month after next?
They'll fly to Stockholm.
Sydney.
Where will you and Stella leave for next week?
We'll leave for Sydney.
Tokyo.
Where will Peter return from this month?
Return from, 从什么地方回来？
He'll return from Tokyo.
这个教学单元中出现了很多种时态，开始你可能会觉得有一点混乱，但是如果你的注意力更多的放在句子的含义上，也就是说根据句子的含义来选择正确的表达方式，这样问题看起来可能就没有那么复杂。好了，今天的课就到这儿了。See you next time.